space, a place that not only we love, but really helps enhance the quality of life for all of us in our community. Now, we weren't able, the City Council and I, to come up with a final proposal. And I decided, and the City Council agreed, look, let's step back, let's spend more time with the community, let's make sure we get this right. So for our Trans Valley trails, like the Nine Line, that's starting to be so successful, to go all the way from Immigration Canyon to the Jordan River and out the canal, to make sure that we get those things right and figure out a whole range of funding sources so that we minimize any impact through bringing these great improvements that will help us enjoy our facilities and that much more. The Jordan River would have been the largest beneficiary by far of that proposal. Three quarters of that money would have gone along the Jordan River, with improvements, with restoration along the Jordan River, with trails, with adding features to get in and out of the river, with putting in areas for crew, for a little play wave coming into the Jordan River, where the surplus canal separates and there's a drop, and would bring people from all over to enjoy this most beautiful, wonderful part of our city.
Talked about, were on your behalf. as a way to fund infrastructure. And yes, the mayor vetoed it. It was overrode. And then what happens? Almost half of that money was spent on salaries. Is that fiscally conservative? It isn't. The other thing I'm going to tell you is nobody in here voted on the bond that's paying for the Broadway Theater. That's over $100 million. And we should have had a vote on that. Because the Broadway Theater may be a good thing, maybe. But nobody in this room got to vote on that. But you're paying for it. And I think that's wrong. That's my last question. I'm going to give you 2 minutes each for a closing statement. And if we have time, we can take a couple of questions from the audience. Ralph?
I think I was last.
You were last? No, Jack. Thank you. Thank you for being here and for taking the time to hear what we have to say. This is a very important election, and it matters to all of us for the next 4 years. I have a very strong collaborative leadership style. I've been on Capitol Hill for 13 years. I worked very diligently with both sides of the aisle. Half of my endorsements from Capitol Hill are coming from very conservative Republicans who are Mormon. Half of them are coming from Democrats, who I worked very closely with for many, many years. Many of you maybe saw the video that my boss, Jim Winder, put out the other day talking about my leadership and the work I've been doing at the Sheriff's Office and how I brought community leaders together to create the Unified Police Department. I also created a communications bridge. We were having real 911 communication problems between VEC and our Salt Lake County Sheriff Dispatch. And within 1 year, I fixed that problem and had the funding and the bridge in place so we could transfer calls without any issue. These are real life-saving decisions that go on when people choose to leave. And I want a chance to leave. I want to represent you. I want to be your voice. I want you to know you have access. I've been handing out my cell phone number and my home phone number this entire campaign. Those two numbers have not changed in 20 years. When I was a legislator, people had the same phone numbers. I'm accessible, and your voice matters to me, and I will be listening just like I have been this whole time. I want to make a difference. Everybody deserves to have the same opportunity to be successful in their life. And I want to help you do that. Please vote for me. Thank you for being here.
So thank you all for coming and staying for this evening. And thank you to the community councils and all of you for helping put this together. You know, when I ran for mayor a few years ago, I knocked on doors, as I have in every campaign across the state. And you know my favorite place to be knocking on doors and talking to people? It was in these neighborhoods. People were welcoming. People were happy to spend a little time to talk to me and give me their ideas. And that approach to serving as mayor, I've taken to heart and have used my entire time as mayor. We have one-on-one meetings where anyone can come in to see me. And I've learned so much from people about cities and ideas and things they don't like that we need to get fixed. And as we go forward, I think we need to look at the wonderful things that have been happening in this city. Look what's happening on North Temple. It is now the most beautiful street in this city. When it comes to investments of our capital and infrastructure, during my administration, we have been putting more money into neighborhood improvements here than in any other part of the city. That's the kind of attention and responsiveness that I know you need and deserve. And in my next 4 years, in my mind, we have just started. Think of what we can do with the Jordan River so it is truly this gem, this ribbon flowing through our city and valley so that we can all enjoy it. Think what we can do with the neighborhood nodes so that 9th and 9th isn't thought about as an east side great place, but a west side great place. We can do so much more, and I hope, as you vote, you have your ballots before you, that you'll continue on this great progress that we've made and allow me to serve another 4 years as your mayor. Thank you.
Thank you both. I apologize, but we actually don't have time for questions from the audience, but I'm sure the candidates will be happy to talk to you on the floor. And really quickly, I wanted to remind everyone that election ballots have arrived and they need to be postmarked by the 2nd, just so all of you know. Thank you all.
Would all the community council chairs please come up to the stage and we're going to take a picture of the candidates real quick. Thanks. Thanks, everybody. Have a nice night.